we always seem to end up back to basically us with something a little bit different. Spock, for example.
Did he always have a bowl cut?
I think he always had a bit of a bowl.
Yeah.
Leonard Nimoy's bowl.
Yeah.
Predator is a guy in a suit.
Mm-hmm.
Spock, a guy with false
ears. Yeah.
Then, of course, we've got the archetypal alien.
In every case, it's basically a humanoid body shape.
All of these seem to lack a bit of imagination to me, looking at them from an evolutionary perspective. There's going to be some rules. I think it's going to be carbon-based. Microbes are going to be important. We're going to see natural selection and evolution.
If I could make one bet about alien life, it would be on that it would evolve. And I don't think I would lose this bet.
Very great thickness of ice, about 10 miles, I think. And underneath, we've seemingly got good evidence that there is liquid water.
I think it's all heated by these volcanic vents.
Which is looking a little bit similar to the sorts of things that we find in the deep ocean here on Earth. We know there's going to be no sunlight getting down.
Oh,
so
yeah, I mean,
they're going to have to be chemosynthetic.
Bacteria would maybe, at some point, start to form symbioses, larger cells, and then you would have maybe the beginnings of multicellular life. Because this is an unstable planet, any kind of life around these vents needs to have a mobile form.
It has to be able to abandon ship and find new vents to live on.
I mean, let's imagine we find something like this tadpole creature. He doesn't have eyes because it's dark.
It's dark down there.
But he does have some way of sensing heat. Let's imagine this guy is actually the first morph of a more complex organism. Maybe you would see him metamorphosizing. He is now turning into his real form, a kind of chemosynthetic large worm. He takes root, actually.
So he's attaching just like the larva of a sea squirt that we find here on Earth.
Yeah.
These mobile forms that can go out, find new habitat, and then start the whole thing all over again.
He's using his tentacles as gardens to cultivate these bacteria and to charge his metabolism. When this probe lands in 15 years, we might be proven right. Something like this might be down there.
When TRAPPIST is orbiting its sun, it stays tidally locked, which means the same face is always facing the sun. One side is getting absolutely baked, and whilst the other side gets no light at all and is very cold. And that line where sun meets shade, this terminator as it's called, is the zone where life might just about be able to exist on TRAPPIST. Like a long, thin island of life.
One side is always sunny, and one side is always dark. So that would imply constant winds flowing one direction. What pass off as trees could be like weather vanes.
You can see this effect on Earth, actually, if you go to the edges of cliffs. You know, with that strong wind blowing, it's going to be quite difficult for these animals to make themselves heard. I think we're going to see animals displaying.
Maybe among the trees, you see something red fluttering about, like a kite. This kind of quasi-bird-like animal with a very long kind of snout. And he uses it to hold on to the tree. What he then does is open up his cape-like wings.
He's trying to attract a mate.
Yeah, he's trying to impress his potential girlfriend here.
Very colorful world.
Yeah.
But a very focused and intense world.
So imagine a line of predators that always stalk from the direction of the sun. Maybe he would have six limbs rather than four.
Which gives you a huge advantage for hanging on and for clambering around. There's no reason at all why this animal couldn't have an extra joint, giving it a little bit more range of movement, more flexibility, because with that lower gravity, it's not taking such a strain. Raptorial legs.
Yeah, exactly.
Legs that can grab and hold.
And it kind of
gives it a huge range.
Watch your back.
Yes. Very high gravity is going to be a big issue.
Everything is kind of flattened out. Maybe one form could be like this flattened slug creature.
Flatworm sort of creature.
You could have a huge variety of these guys.
Given that the planet's been around for 2 billion years, longer than Earth has, might we find the evolution of intelligent life?
Because of the size constraints, I think intelligent life would begin from a colonial perspective, just like a group of ants collaborating together. If you were to see these guys, they would look like very intelligently guided swarm of little shapes moving across the floor and coming towards you. Maybe they would form different shapes or letters trying to communicate.
The idea of all these subunits, these little individual things coming together and creating not just a colony, but something that's got intelligence and can travel across space really appeals to me.
Certainly, the whole issue of contamination by alien bacteria, I think it's the one thing we can't protect against.
It's what we saw in the history of recent history of humans as we've gone across through the world spreading things like smallpox. So in a way, that's a study in miniature of what would happen perhaps if an alien culture were to come here. We're going to need some sort of galactic quarantine.
Yeah, or a galactic hospital.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that, be sure to check out these videos next. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get a notification each time we upload a new video.